Dave Ramsey recently claimed that an 8% withdrawal rate from an investment portfolio is safe for retirees. Safe withdrawal rates estimate the percentage of a portfolio that can be spent in the first year and then adjusted for inflation thereafter without a material risk of running out of money. Dave's logic is that good mutual funds return around 12% per year, and inflation has averaged around 4% for the last 80 years. This leaves 8% to be spent by the retiree. Unfortunately, the logic is flawed, and retirement spending math does not work this way. Good mutual funds are hard to find before the fact, so the idea that you can easily pick a market-beating fund is a flimsy assumption. The best-performing funds historically do not tend to go on to be the best-performing funds in the future. A similar comment can be made about country returns. Dave references the performance of the S&P 500 as being a little below 12%, but again, the phenomenal historical performance of the S&P 500 does not mean that future returns for U.S. stocks will be similarly high. It would be far more sensible, at least in my opinion, to use return experiences of countries around the world to gain an understanding of possible return scenarios in planning for retirement. When you do this, the safe withdrawal rate is closer to 3% or even a little lower. Even if we could find a fund that does return 12% on average, it would not sustain an 8% withdrawal rate for the simple reason that stock returns are not constant. That 12% average return will consist of lots of big ups and downs, and inflation also goes through higher and lower periods. Constantly spending an inflation-adjusted 8% of the initial portfolio during consecutive down years, or having to keep up with years of higher inflation without offsetting higher returns, can deplete a portfolio quickly. Let's take a mutual fund that has returned about 12% per year since 1935, the American Funds Investment Company of America. It returned 11.73% annualized from 1934 through October 2023, which is incredible. Now, as a side note, despite its incredible long-term track record, this fund has trailed the U.S. market for more than 20 years as of today. You can't buy past performance. But anyway, using this fund's historical performance to test an 8% withdrawal in the first year, followed by annual inflation adjustments, so a constant real $80,000 in spending on $1 million portfolio, over a 30-year period, yields a success rate of a little more than 50%. This means that in around 50% of simulated trials, you ran out of money before the end of the 30-year withdrawal period. I don't know about you, but I would not call that safe. At a 5% failure rate, the safe withdrawal rate for this fund, which we know has a great historical track record, would be about 4.6%. Come on, Dave. Be better.